May this altar be signed, sanctified, and consecrated in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. in honor of God and under the title of Christ the King.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Let my prayer, Lord, rise like incense in your sight, and let your Christian people win abundant blessings, so that everyone who devoutly offers gifts for consecration on this altar, or receives what has been consecrated, may obtain help for this present life, gain the remission also of all his sins, and receive the grace of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We praise them up to the Lord.
It is meet and right, our duty and profitable to salvation, always and everywhere to thank you, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Everlasting God. And so that we may perform the rites of worship with more zealous care and more attentive service, we beg of you to bless and sanctify this church, in which Christ is invoked as King, in holy reverence, and to give him honor, we dedicate this altar to your most holy name. Therefore, through his earnest prayers, Lord, graciously pour forth holiness from heaven and bless this altar. Let angels of light stand near, and let it be bright with the radiance of the Holy Spirit. Let it have the same favor with you as the altar which Abraham, the father of our faith, erected when he was about to sacrifice his son as a type of our redemption, as the altar which Isaac raised in the sight of your majesty, as that which Jacob built when in a mighty vision he beheld the Lord. Here grant our prayers, sanctify our offerings, bless what is placed upon the altar, distribute also what you have blessed. So let the title of this church be everlasting, its table set for a heavenly and spiritual banquet. Therefore, Lord, with your own mouth, bless the offerings placed upon this altar, and having blessed, accept them, and grant to all of us who share in them to acquire everlasting life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who being God, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Christus, Christus, Regnat, Christus, in per mat. Christus, regit, Christus, regnat, Christus, in per mat. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. Today, my dear brethren, is a day for rejoicing, but it's also a day for remembering. And we remember, in the first place, Dr. Downey, the Archbishop who created the slogan, "A Cathedral in Our Time," and told Sir Edwin Lutyens to build it. In God's providence, he was not to remain on earth to see the cathedral, but many thousands who eagerly followed his first call are alive today to thank God that they have had some share in giving Liverpool, at last, its Metropolitan Cathedral. This is a day to remember the famine-stricken Irish who brought new life to the Catholic Church in Liverpool. Broken in health, destitute, they nevertheless preserved the rich treasure of their faith. And by work and sacrifice, they were determined to provide churches in this city for Catholic worship and schools where their children could be instructed in the old faith. They and their children, under God, are responsible for the sturdy Catholic life in this great city. It is good today to recall these men and women and to recall the great sacrifices they made, because this is their cathedral. It is built as a monument to Christ the King, but it will serve as a memorial to the Catholic priests and people of Lancashire and of this city of Liverpool, who struggled so hard to build up the church in the north. I am here as the representative of Pope Paul. Therefore, it would not be fitting for me to express at any length my own satisfaction as a former Archbishop of Liverpool that the great day has come for the North, when the Catholic people have their Metropolitan Cathedral. I congratulate the Archbishop, his clergy, and all the people of Lancashire and of Liverpool on the successful fulfillment of the hopes of many generations. The whole Catholic community rejoices with them. Last of all, I salute the representative of the Queen, and I ask him if he would convey to Her Majesty the affectionate greetings of her loyal Catholic citizens. May God bless you all during this Mass this afternoon. And in the name of the Holy Father, I pray that God will bless all of every faith who come here to honor God. May the kingdom of Christ come quickly. Amen.
Quam patoritur, accepit panem in sanctas ac venerables manus suas, et elevatis oculis in celum, ad te Deum Patrem suum omnipotentem, tibi gratias agens, benedixit, fregit, dedicque discipulis suis dicens, accipite et manducate ex hoc omnes. Hoc est enim corpus meum. Simile modo postquam genatum est, accipiens et hunc precarum calicem in sanctas ac venerables manus suas, item tibi gratias agens, benedixit, dedicque discipulis suis digens, accipite et bibite ex eo omnes. Hic est enim calix sanguinis mei, novi et aeterni testamenti, mysterium fidei, qui pro vobis et pro multis effundetur, in remissionem peccatorum. Hic cruces cumque fecetis, in me memoriam facietis.
Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.